Ronnie Dahl here from 4wheeling and westernaustralia.com. Welcome to a different type of video. This video I'm going to go through my tool bag, the tools I carry out in the bush. So just general stuff, not like your special bush mechanic tools. Might touch on it slightly, but this is mainly for general tools, so not spare parts or anything like that. And then you guys can get an idea of what you might need, because I'm going to get two mechanics to come in and I just need them to appear first. All right, how you going, guys?
Yeah, good, thanks, Ronnie.
Simon. Travis.
Once again.
All right, so Simon, you've done Rhino Challenge.
Rhino Charge.
Yeah, so you've Rhino Charge, is it?
Yeah, Rhino Charge.
So you've been carrying a lot of tools, I take it then, for...
Stuck in the bush.
For some crazy off-road
hours,
stuff. Yeah. And you used to have an 80 series, used to do a bit of four-wheel driving yourself?
Yeah, back in the day when I was younger.
Back in the day, yeah. All right, so I've got two expert mechanics here, and we are going to go through my tools first, and then we're going to probably subtract a few things. We have had a brief look at it, so we're not completely stumped on what we got here. We're definitely going to add some things to it, I know that. So I'm just going to get the trolley. So here we go. We'll start with the obvious, and it's going to be a bottle jack.
You have a high lift jack as well?
I've got two at home. I've got a short one and a long one. So I'm glad you asked that, because if you've got a high lift, you need the longer one. And if you don't have such a high lift, you can get away with a shorter one. But I just don't like them. I think they're too dangerous. So I've gone for the bottle jack, and usually someone else will carry a high lift.
And with the jack, have you got a platform to sit it on or to jack off of?
Yes, to jack off with, yeah. I have a wooden board, like a scaffold plank, which I'll put underneath.
Yeah. Otherwise, this is going to be rendered.
Yeah, it's just going to sink into the ground.
All right.
Especially on the beach.
And?
8 tonne.
8 tonne, that's good.
Yeah.
And it's capable.
Use it a couple of times, and it does lift the wheel up substantially, because that's actually a truck jack.
Does it get under... The axle, no, it doesn't, so you have to just put it under a spring.
Yeah, I have to put it under one of the springs there. So I can only really lift one side at a time. Yeah. While we're on it, tire iron. I only have one, though.
Two off, normally, or...?
Well, no, I've only got one. I'm supposed to have two, but usually someone else will carry on, but I shouldn't rely on that. So, you know, you obviously need two to take a tire on and off.
Yep.
And then... Oh, tire repair kits. With an absolute bucket load of spare valve
Schraders, yeah. And lube, they're in good nick too. Your spikes, they're not bent. Probably one of the more importantly.
Yeah, so you can change your valve core.
Yeah, change it, thread repair, whatever you need to do there. That's good. Yep. All right.
And a pair of pliers in there too.
Yep. Yeah, so you can pull out whatever's in the tyre as well.
Yeah. General tools. Now these two bags live under my front seat, on my driver's seat.
So it's your quick grab tool bag then, access pretty easy.
Quick grab kit. Because I find that when something happens, everyone has their tools buried underneath everything.
Yeah, last, yeah.
Yeah, and we're always going to be late or something, because we've got to pull everything out.
The only thing I'd say to that is if you can find some heavy duty quick release tie wraps to secure under the seat, because if you have a roll or something like that, things in there are heavy, you don't want them getting in the way of your feet or rolling around the car or things like that.
That's a good
just
point.
Just tie them under the seat, it's nice to have them on. You know, quick to get to, but safety as well.
So Allen keys, metric and imperial. Then I'll put these on wires so I don't lose any.
Yeah.
And I don't get dirty.
It's not a bad idea.
And they pack in easier.
Obviously what we're looking for straight away, obviously your car being a Toyota is a metric, but if your car is Imperial or you need to have it relative to what the vehicle is.
Yep, so and all of them are metric.
Yeah, which is fine for your vehicle, but consider that as a general, doing this as a general toolkit. Yeah.
General toolkit, yeah.
7mm there?
Yeah, there's 8, 7 here, yeah. So you've got your hose clamps, that's what we're looking for.
Yeah, so I've got one for the small socket set.
Quarter drive,
one for the big.
3/8.
One of these to measure bolts with. I'll just pour the rest out. Alright, so what we got here. So you're probably going to tell me I've got too many cutting devices, because I do have a lot of cutting devices. So I have a mini pair of bowl cutters. Cutters for wire. Yeah. Pliers.
Stub nose pliers, yeah.
Long nose pliers with cutters. My Nipex. Well, they're all Nipex, but they are, I call these my nips for my construction days. And I'll show you some wire later. This is my most handy tool for bush mechanics with wire.
Yeah, I have seen.
I'll give you a small preview later. Cars
come back.
Yeah. It's pretty cool, this little
multi-grips.
Thing. Multi-grips, yep. And then just a general screwdriver kit. These are all the small ones. Small screwdrivers.
Probably need one bigger one than that.
I do have in here a bigger one, but I don't have my flat anymore. Yeah, flat blade's gone.
You can lose like a tail lever as well, and you know, you can
just it's a bit useful for a lot more stuff. And then just my general spanner kit.
Three-eighths.
The only issue with sometimes with some of these is they're quite fat, and you can't get them into, sometimes like if you've got to take a prop shaft off, these won't actually get in to the, and if it's tight, the open end here will slip on the nut, and then you're stuck. So as quick and convenient as they are, they're probably not the most ideal spanner to have in your safari kit, per se, because...
So you recommend if I do have this, have the regular ones?
Yeah, which are thinner.
So here's my 14, so just show the audience the one you're talking about.
This is what we'd recommend. It's got a much narrower sort of head around it. It's got a slight angle, so it gives you a few more options as into areas you can get into. And it lets you get into much more accessible areas with a narrower head, basically.
Yeah, I can see that. So basically this black bit in here, that's what that thickness is there. Okay. All right.
The other thing we'd suggest is some more grips.
Locking vice grips.
You can, if you've got a rounded nut or something, you'll be able to get a nice firm grip on this so you can carry on undoing it. The other good thing is if you end up with a broken brake pipe, you can pinch a rubber pipe with this and it will stop the brake leak.
Oh, that's a good idea. I used to have one in my kit, but I took it out because I was starting to colour a lot of stuff.
Radiator hose, heater hose, all sorts of things you can pinch with that.
Okay, mention that, I'll come back in.
Do away with them, replace them with them, because you've got your bolt cutters. You can still cut with them if you need to, which you can do, and also you've got a cutting edge on here as well.
Okay, so we can get rid of those.
Get rid of them, gain them. The other thing I'd see with the socket set, you've only got one short extension there. Not that you need to have too much, but even another shorter one, so you can make it longer or shorter. Or
for the half inch, definitely.
For the three-eighths.
Well, have you got anything with a quarter?
Well, this is where we come into here. I don't have any more for that one, no.
Yeah, okay. You might do. Actually, you have got this, actually, here. So you've got a little hand, which is good for your hose clamps.
That is actually my most used tool when it comes to those little sockets.
Yeah. For your small stuff, it's pretty much hand torque anyway.
Yeah.
So that's more than adequate.
Mm. But this is excellent.
Yeah.
I can't, rave on about how much.
Well, actually, probably fine. Your hose clamps is more than tight enough with hand with that anyway.
Yeah, the thing is, you might not be able to get it in somewhere. So
because it's so long.
You know, because the hose will sit there. So it does.
Be handy. Yeah, we've got, I don't know how many extensions here, so.
Yeah, good point. And this is my socket set here. And I've culled all the Imperial. What I have instead is this multi thing here. It's probably not that great, but it might get me out, it might get a different vehicle out of trouble. Yeah. It might carry Imperial. But I know I've got to put these back in because.
What size have you got?
A 27 and a 30 on a Toyota. You'll need. They are used in a couple of areas.
Okay. Where will the 30 be used?
The 30 is used on the diff flange. The pinion flange.
Yeah.
So you see, obviously, you culled all that with your car being metric, but yeah, like you say, in lieu of...
Of taking some of the bigger metrics out.
Yeah, that's fine.
So with all these sizes here, I know I've got to put these ones back in, the bigger ones. I mean, I took them out because of weight, but as you pointed out, they're useful, or they're needed, required. So with the wheel bearings, though, the front ones, there's a different thing.
That's where we have this special wheel bearing.
And what size is that?
This is a 55. Now... A Nissan's a 54. If you have a 55.
So that's a 55.
This is a 55, and the Nissan's a 54, but actually we'll do both. I mean, because you're 1 mil out on such a big nut.
Oh, on such a big nut.
So if you are travelling with a Nissan, then obviously you can assist.
Yeah, so but if a Nissan's travelling with a...
If it has a 50S, then it won't go, you won't miss out. So, yeah, that's an ABW socket. I think you're roughly $50 or something like that.
Yeah, I ordered one online.
Yeah. I mean, look, it's worth having. Otherwise, we see guys with... You can do it with a chisel on the side of the road to get that nut undone if you got to get home.
Mm.
You know, a screwdriver, or but you end up marking it.
If you get into a chisel, you don't have any chisels in here either.
Yeah, no, so, and I don't have any coming up either.
And touching on those wheel bearings, you don't have any punches or anything to change shells or...
No, I don't.
Which, just a general punch, sort of make one that sort of does everything. You don't want a punch kit. Obviously, the more steel and weight you're going to add is what we don't want to run. So I'd say... run with a punch and a chisel.
When you go and you've got your baked bean tins and things, if you ever put a hole in something, you can cut off a baked bean tin with your chisel and a small hammer and use it as a patch with a bit of silicone, which I see you don't have in your kit either. Sort of cut the shape that you want, put a bit of silicone, clean up the area, dry it, put the silicone on, and the baked bean tin will...
You know, that's special silicone you got there.
We sort of use this grey silicone. We find it's really good multi-purpose. You can remake gaskets with it. You can use it as a sealant. All sorts of things.
It's very multi-use.
So it's pretty, you know.
Okay.
So, yeah, if you've got a hole in your fuel tank or something, in emergency, with a baked bean can tin, you could probably get yourself home, you know, trying to patch it or something like that.
Good one, which is one of my favourites, is a through-tang screwdriver. So obviously there's still metal end, so you can actually hit it with the end of it. And saying that, obviously, I can't see you've got a hammer in...
No, I'll use the axe.
Yeah, which is probably what I used to do. Obviously,
yeah.
Having a workshop hammer, it's more weight, room, the axe will do the job. Obviously, having that, you probably, if you're not too attached to the screwdriver and you need to use it as a chisel or a punch, you can get away with it. It'll do what you need to do if you hit it a bit harder.
And just going back on this set here, right? My ratchet set here. You mentioned before breaker bar.
Yeah, look, I did notice with your 3.8 here, you've only got this 3.8 here, but what you'll need, you've got no leverage with this, so then you've obviously got to step up, go get your half-inch kit.
Yeah.
But still, you've only got this much leverage. Obviously, we're a bit spoiled in the workshop. We've got breaker bars and what have you, but a piece of galvanised tube, it's really heavy duty. You can use it for anything. You can actually use the end for striking. It fits your half-inch. But then one thing I did notice, so that'll go with your half inch, is your 3.8 doesn't go in the ends. So I'd either pull the rubber off, get another ratchet, or obviously like our 3.8 one slides down the end. Leaf pack, crack a leaf or something, you can always put a ratchet strap around it, support something, can prop something up. It's gonna be pretty useful. So as you can see, the ends of this pipe are pretty well used.
Okay.
I mean, you can use it for punching things as well, you know, so. Just depends on what you need to do.
Yeah.
So a piece of galvanised pipe will always be handy.
Anti-theft deterrent.
Yeah. Attitude adjuster.
All right, so we are nearly towards the end of my kit. Okay, it's kind of going to go into a little bit of spare part-ish kind of area, but it's the fine line of tools and spare parts. So. We're not talking about these, that's just, I don't know, I think I'm pretty clever putting them there. It kind of keeps the thing shut. Super glue.
Is it gel or is it the runny one?
I have no idea, I haven't opened it yet.
The only thing I'll find, obviously you've got the super glue that's a gel. When you're trying to glue something together with it, like if you're trying to glue a hose or it'll stay where you put it, doesn't not run away.
Oh, okay, well, there's the liquid stuff. Yeah, yeah, I had that problem with Loctite,
Yeah, so that's what I'd say.
So the gel type, I didn't even think
better,
about that.
Yeah,
that's a good point.
Yeah.
Okay, I got emergency repair tape, and I have used this before. This is really good stuff. You can feel this one here is light as, because I used a fair bit. I'll stop the fuel leak.
That's very mild, mate.
You can put that around.
You can put it around hot as well.
I mean, if you strip back wiring harness and expose, anything like that,
And with that, patches. So you can, if there's pressure.
Yes.
Like on your heater hose. What the hell is that? Oh, that's some passable air down kit. So don't worry about that. Ah, here we go. The wire for the Nipex. We better get the Nipex back out.
Yeah, we'll grab them. Your favourite, I think. I've seen them used many times.
Yeah, this has been 18 years of my life, my bread and butter. This stuff here goes hand in hand. I've tied CV boots on with this. I've tied all kinds of things up. I've even clamped hoses with this stuff on other people's vehicles. I've done heaps of stuff with this.
I actually think you got the CV boots on your Hilux tighter than I could with a CV boot clamp. So I was pretty impressed.
It's good stuff, if you know how to tie.
Yeah.
I know how to tie.
Next video.
It's one thing I'm good at. Yeah, next video. Gas solder. I even keep the gas in there somewhere. But yeah, that's still cool. Full.
And you've got solder?
Yes. Good question.
Yep.
Cool. I do have solder. Okay, so then I've got these two. I'll lock your opinion on these. So I've got this metal repair. It's like the stuff you mend in your hands and then...
Yeah, okay, you can put on fuel tanks or radiators. Or...
Yeah. So how do you rate that kind of stuff?
Probably pretty good.
Is it two-part or one's two different brands?
It's one part. That's aluminium and that is steel.
No, I mean, you can drill and tap it. I mean, obviously you're doing it as a repair. You're not trying to make a permanent fix. I mean, it'll work perfectly fine. I mean,
just doing it to get out.
Get you home, yeah. It's definitely going to serve its purpose.
Oh, another super glue.
But it's good to see it hasn't been used.
Yeah, well, that one hasn't.
So, 100 mile an hour tape?
Duct tape. You've got to have duct tape. Electrical tape.
Yeah.
I could probably get rid of the electrical tape though, couldn't I?
Yeah. Just handy sometimes it's small if you want to get it around in a smaller area. I think it's...
Yeah.
It's not... I didn't say it's going to take up a lot of room.
And look, the rest of the stuff in here is just general and camping stuff and kind of spare part kind of, you know, I'll put these...
But obviously you've got a set of gloves there.
Yeah, set of gloves.
I mean, look, I think not a bad idea if you're doing wheel bearing or something. I mean, do you have hand cleaner?
I have rubber gloves that are latex rubber gloves. Yeah, they're quite tight. Yep. I use them as diesel gloves as well.
Yeah, so like when you did your wheel bearing, so what did you clean your hands with after?
Oh, I got my mechanical hero to do that. I had a mechanical fitter with me, if I did, I would have worn gloves, yeah.
Yeah, I'd say, because then when you're done, it's off and you don't try to go back through your car and look and you've got grease and...
And by the time I offered him the gloves, it was too late.
Yeah, he's elbow deep in it. Yeah.
Hose clamps.
Bit more of a size range, maybe, you know. Check to see what your car needs. Mm. Intake hose clamps as well. That's something maybe, you know, one, usually going to be one of all the same size.
Also, if you have a couple, you can join them together to make them longer.
Oh, can you?
So if you get the same size, you can undo this, feed into the next one, and you can double the...
A bit like a zip tie, I mean.
Yeah, kind of. You can add, you know, two or three, whereas it's a different brands, you can't. So if you get the same, you know, same sort brand. Of make and whatever, you can add, make multiple ones to cover something bigger or whatever you need to.
Because you'll find with the air intake pipes as well, sometimes if they've been through a lot of mud, water like yours, if you undo them and they bind up,
they're not
that friendly to get back on. So,
yeah.
So you got zip ties there?
Yeah, I've got zip ties. Yeah, now, I do carry all different sizes, but they're out at home. A lot of my electrical kit is out because I've been doing a bit of electrical stuff at home. So, yeah, zip ties. And
one thing I'll say with them, buy the black ones, buy good quality. Oh, I'm a strong believer of you get what you pay for with zip ties. You'll find the white ones, aren't you,
UV stable? Nylon.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you're not going to go down the road with your roof, something on your roof rack and the sun scorched it and...
Yeah, true.
You know, you see it all the time, the white ones are...
A bit like that wire, stuff to put the wire through, what it was called, the channeling.
Yes, the flexi channel.
Yeah. I've seen people use the office cable one, and it melts on the engine.
Yeah, because it's very thin wall and...
Yeah, not heat resistant.
Rag?
Rags, yep.
Yep.
Let's just go to this stuff here. Inox 3.
I'll rate that.
All over the engine bay and the chassis after I've cleaned it, of course.
Yeah.
Makes it look all nice and fresh as well. Yeah. I actually had people going, when did you get a new tow assembly? Did you smash the other one? So, no, I just sprayed it with this stuff.
I think it's good.
And I know you like this one, Simon.
Yeah, it's great.
WD-40.
Lots of uses. Cold start, cleaning wet things, lubricating items.
Plus, that's obviously this... How that flips up, I think it's quite handy because every time you get the can, you're like, where's that little stalk gone?
Yeah.
It's in the bottom of your toolkit. That's good, it's on there.
Because normally you have that sticky toe, right?
Yeah.
And it falls out.
Yeah.
Okay.
Ratchet straps, I see you got there.
Yep, ratchet straps. So I've got like just my normal tie down for the roof rack, but I still find it useful to hold stuff down with.
Yeah,
it's a real quick one. But you obviously can't beat the strength of one of these.
No, definitely.
And I do carry some thicker green ones as well. Colour doesn't matter, they're all different size anyway.
Yeah, I mean, if you break something, like I was saying back with that tube, you can wrap that around it. I've actually seen people get home with a ratchet strap and some tie wire and a
Usually it's ratchet straps and tie wire and
Yeah, it'll get you. It's amazing what you'll do when you have to do it.
Yeah, I've held a roof rack on with one of these before, on my Hilux.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, the custom bolts just snapped off, had to hold it down. So now onto the final part of what I have in my kit, and then we're gonna, you guys are gonna add some stuff to it, but you've probably still got some comments to make here. Now, a wire cutter and, well, yeah, and crimper.
Strippers and crimpers.
And, yeah, and stripper as well, all in one. I did used to carry the big one, but you...
Yeah, it's a bit overboard, yeah, I think.
Your time was a bit overboard.
Multimeter.
Yes.
Yeah.
Very important.
Make sure it works.
Yeah, and the battery's charged, it's not left on.
The worst part is if you don't know how to use them, because I've blown up one already. And this is my third one, by the way, because I've blown up two.
Well, that'll probably be another video you can run through.
Yeah, I just forget how to use them sometimes, so I've got to write it down.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Laminate something on the back, just for quick check.
Just for 12 volt, because if you use the wrong thing.
Yeah. That or a test light, I'd probably say for someone that isn't competent with this, a test light can run through fuses. Just, that's what I used to have, because, you know, 10 years ago, there was no such thing as a cheap meter. But now, I mean, what would you pay for that? $30.
Yeah, 30
probably
bucks.
You can get $15, I think, now. Mm. You're not exactly...
How do you rate them?
Yeah. They'll get you to most of what you need, if you know how to use it.
Yeah, that's...
If you know how to use it.
Yeah, that's what I'd probably say. For the room, that's going to take up for what you're going to probably do. It's good if you want to know what a voltage is, but to find fuses and power, a test light is probably more than sufficient.
Because what I just use a basic use is just to see, is there power coming here? Yeah. Oh, okay, so the problem's further back.
Yes.
Or further forward. And then... I have some spade fuses, and these ones I didn't realize until I actually blew a fuse that, hang on, the VDJs are using these tiny micro fuses, which I just bought a whole heap of.
And you only get so many spares in your car.
Yeah, because I had to pay, what, 10 bucks a fuse, out the middle of nowhere, and they only had two, and I blew one trying to find where the problem was, and then I kept the other one for... later.
10 bucks a pop, you'd be looking hard.
Then I also have this container here, which has more electrical tape, a red one, better quality than the other one, smaller zip ties, specific fuses. I don't know, what do you call these ones?
They're like maxi fuses. The maxi fuses are the big ones you run in your compressor. These are like the midis. They're mainly in your BCDC.
They're hard to get.
Yeah.
They're very hard to get. So this is one time where I highly recommend eBay is for these kind of fuses, because I had a place trying to slug me 50 bucks for one of those. I kid you not.
I mean, if you walk in somewhere that's working on your car and ask them, hey, what fuses are in my car? That's the best thing, obviously, if you see a fuse board or, you know what your car needs before you go away. Well, and obviously... Yeah.
Importantly is obviously these will run the car, but most of your accessories will use a different type of fuse.
Yeah,
so
usually
this
size. Make
sure you understand what fuses your accessories need and that you've got them.
Ampage on them too.
And generally, how many times have you had a fuse from the car wiring go rather than the accessories? 9 times out of 10, it'll probably be your accessories.
Or accessories causing it.
Yeah, and that can be come down to a bit of fitting. Mm. So that's why we say to know your accessories and try and get whoever's installing, if you're going to multiple places, keep a standard.
All the same fuse size.
You're not carrying midis, maxis, this, glass fuses with blade fuses, like your CB.
I carry all of them.
So as I say, you have glass fuses for your CB.
But actually, that's a good point.
Because that's your communication source as well. So even if you can't get home, you don't have a radio.
Mm.
I mean, okay, you could bypass a fuse. Yeah. Yeah, go mate.
Okay, so now to some additional things you're going to add to my kit.
Not too much. Bit of emery cloth. Obviously, you can have your standard wet and dry, but in the bush, in your car, this has got a cloth backing to it, so you can screw it up. Okay. It could get oil, grease, diesel, whatever
you
want on it.
So you wouldn't recommend paper?
Oh, look, you can, but you'll usually find over the years in the bottom of your toolkit or something, you'll go get it out, and it just disintegrated. It's like a box of matches that's wet. It's not good to you. That can tolerate a bit more. Yeah, yeah. Or like a leftover or a belt sander, or, you know, if you've got something else at home that you're only using it just to rub something down, or if you need to, get a flat surface or anything. A file. half round and flat.
Would you recommend those tiny files as well? Because when I did my wheel bearing, the Fred Yuha, who helped me out with it, he cleaned it up with his tiny little files.
Yeah, because that's what I was going to submit. Someone was just talking about. You could use that.
Oh, use the
you
edge.
Could yeah. You could file off the thread. So say this is the thread here. You could just file away the edge. You know, if you've got a bolt, say, you know, you're trying to start the end of the bolt, you could file the starting threads. So then it just drops in, then you can start, you know. I mean, it just depends on how much room you've got. Look, the small files aren't going to take much weight. Mm. You don't need much. But yeah, definitely I'd say a file. And then the other one when you talk about threads, or you could have a thread file, but just depends on how far you want to go, is a small wire brush. You know, if you've got debris, sand, grit in your threads, you can clean them. You know, it's pretty universal.
Contacts,
For the battery terminals, one this size.
Yeah,
is
actually,
adequate.
In touching back on that, like Simon said, then, you know, this stuff here rolls up really. I mean, normal wet and dry does. But you can roll this up.
You use on your contacts and your brushes on your alternator. Brush kit.
That rolls up and it will stay good. You know, like I said, that can get wet, diesel, whatever you want on it.
Anything else?
Look, you could take carby cleaner or a parts cleaner if you wanted to.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, like Simon mentions as well, the WD-40, you can start the car on it. This will have, if it's a petrol though, you have a bit more. I mean, that'll still start it, but this is a solvent air dry. So if you're trying to clean something and you want it to clean off.
So is that brake cleaner?
Yes. It is actually brake cleaner, but it'll flash dry. That's what we used to clean the catch can with. So, dirty airflow meter, if you have to. You know, if your air filter's failed or you've got water in there, you can wash dirt and mud off with that. It's pretty safe.
Okay.
I mean, there's a special spray you can get for it, but.
So what is this actual stuff here? Is there other brands that do the same thing?
It doesn't have chlorine in it, which is a good base. From when I've sort of looked around, doesn't stain things, flashes dry, doesn't affect your brakes. So if you have the wheel bearing failure and you've got grease and whatever, all of your brake pads and rotors, that's what it's actually designed for.
So we've now got the whole kit in this black tub here and we're going to weigh it. All right, let's do it. Oh, what's your guess?
What do you reckon? I reckon it'll be...
24,
26.
40. You reckon 40?
Where
are we at? 32, 1.
Oh. I said 26.
You're closer. You can have a beer.
Yeah, that's it. I think it's all right. It's actually probably more room than weight. But like you say, if you pack it well.
Yeah, I mean, we did just chuck it in, right?
Yeah, exactly. So,
Like and I mean, two of the bags are under my front seat. The other stuff is sort of packed away. I mean, that's like if I need to change a tire, I've got to get a heap of stuff out anyway, right?
Yep.
Tire repair kit, easy access, tag along tools, plugging tires all the time.
And going back to that, the jack there as well, if you've got a normal bottle jack in your car, you could probably discard that
which
keep
I have.
That. So,
yeah.
You know, there's that jack on its own would be
definitely
a fair bit of weight.
All right, well, let's get rid of this tub to start with. All right. Thank you very much for your time. You guys are very busy today.
No worries, Ronnie.
And I think we'll have to do another video on spare parts, probably specifically to this vehicle, but it's going to kind of go into other vehicles as well. And with your bush mechanic stories before, I think we'll have to touch on that in a separate video as well. Maybe even get an old bunkie and go out and do them. That'll be cool. All right, guys, well, I don't need you anymore, so. So, thanks again to Travis and Simon. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. I hope it gave you some good pointers and some good tips. I'll have the full list below. You can subscribe right here. And if you'd like to support the creation of content like this, you can go over here to patreon.com/ronniedahl. Thanks for watching. Check out this other video down here and I'll see you in the next video.